I have a Sprint Boot application, stateless, and I need to secure it with Sprint Security 6. I will use a JWT, web filters, and the security context. The authentication is a critical point in the application, and its implementation must be as easy as possible. The more complexity I add, the more errors it can contain, and I don't want it. With Sprint Security 6, I can easily configure the protected routes and the way a user needs to authenticate. And of course, the JWT is the easiest way to secure a stateless application. A JWT is a JSON Web Token. It allows me to store some user information, such as the user ID, name, validity date, and other properties. Never critical information, such as passwords or credit card numbers. The backend creates the JWT and sends it to the frontend. The frontend will then use it for each request in the authorization header. The presence of the JWT in the request will authenticate the request. A JWT has three parts: the header to store the algorithm used to create the token, the payload contains the user data, and the signature. To generate the signature, it uses a secret key and the first two ports of the token. As I don't want to check in all the controllers and services the validity of the JWT, I will need something else. I will use the web filters. The web filters are placed before and after each controller. They are called sequentially before entering a controller, and when exiting a controller, they are called again. By default, I have filters for the security context, the anonymous authentication, session management, exception handling, and more. And I can add my custom filters in between. I will add two filters. The first one will be to check the presence and validity of the JWT for each request. And the second one must be the regular authentication, the authentication with the username and password, because the end user needs to authenticate in a way before trusting him and creating him a JWT. Once I authenticate a request via the password or the JWT, what can I do? I will fill the security context. The security context contains the information about the authenticated user in an object. This object allows me to save the user object when the authentication was already done, the credentials if I still need to authenticate the request, and the roles if I already know all about the authenticated user. Let's now configure all of this in a single bin. I first need to include the Sprint Security dependency in my POM XML. By default, Sprint Boot 3 uses Sprint Security 6, and Sprint Security 6 requires Java 17. I will also include a library to create and validate the JWT. Let's now start with the first filter, the username and password filter. I extend the once per request filter because I only need this filter to be run once per request. I only want this filter to check the sign-in URL. I read the credentials from the request. Validate the credentials with the provider, and if it's correct, fill the security context. Otherwise, clear the security context and throw the exception. And at the end, always call the do filter to continue with the other filters. I will create the provider in a minute. Let's continue now with the JWT filter. I extend the same filter as before. Inject the provider again, which will validate the JWT. I read the JWT which is present in the authorization header. If it's present and it's a bearer token, I try to validate it. Otherwise, clear the security context and throw an exception. And always at the end of each filter, call the do filter. Let's see now what the user provider looks like. I must annotate it with the component annotation to be accessible to inject it anywhere. To generate and validate the JWT, I need a secret key. I will put this secret key in the configuration file and inject it here. I inject the authentication service, just to validate the credentials of the request against the database. To avoid having the secret key readable in the JVM, I will encode it in base 64. When creating a token, I put a validity of 1 hour. After that, the user will need to sign in again. Inside the token, I store the login information, the creation date, and the validity date. Here I have an existing token. This method will throw an exception if the JWT is expired, so I don't need to check this. If the token is valid, I just go look for the user and create the authentication user bin. Finally, I also need to validate a user request which comes with the credentials. Let's continue creating the Sprint Security configuration. I will add those filters and protect my endpoints. I need to enable the web security. The provider is necessary for the filters, and the entry point is the one which handles the exceptions in the response body. I want to talk about this bin. I start by adding the entry point to manage the exceptions. I add now the two filters I've created. I want the JWT filter first, then the username password filter. All this before any other authentication filter of Spring. I disable the CSRF for now. I say that I'm in a stateless application. I won't need any session management. And now permit only the sign in and sign up request without the authentication. The rest of the requests need an authenticated user. finally build the security configuration and return it. I've configured my Sprint security. I've added the filters and the JWT creation to fill the security context. Let's now see how can I use the authenticated user. Now in the controllers, I can use the authentication principle annotation. This annotation injects the user bin from the security context. This means that if the request reaches the controller, this object will have the value of the authenticated user. I need this endpoint to allow the user to authenticate via a username and a password. After the authentication is successful, I return a JWT. The JWT will be then used for the following request in the HTTP header. Let's start now the application and see how it works. I first call the signin method. I will send the credentials in a JSON format. The login and the password. This endpoint returns me the JWT. Let's now use it in some other endpoint. I will use the JWT in the authorization header. Now this protected endpoint returns me the result. Let's make a quick recap. I've added the dependency of Sprint Security and ensure I'm using Java 17. I've added the JWT filter to read and validate the JWT in the HTTP header for each request. I've added the username password filter to read and validate the username and the password for the signing endpoint. I've then created the Sprint Security configuration by adding the filters, the protected URLs, exception handling, and session management. Finally, the signin endpoint. I must return the created JWT if the user signed it in correctly, with its username and password. That's all for today. Remember to subscribe to my channel and click on the like button. Bye!